So anyone ever hear that saying, it has to get worse before it gets better? Anyone think that? A couple of you? Maybe? Oh, hey! That's what I was going to say. It's already worse. It's going to get worse and get worse. In fact, it doesn't get better until it gets better. It doesn't get better until you fight for it to get better. It doesn't get better by getting worse. Look in the newspaper yesterday. There's a guy in Tennessee who, this is their way they're dealing with their budget cuts. The fire department has a new law on the books that says you have to make sure you pay a certain amount of money in order for us to put out fires if they happen at your house. So in the poor neighborhood in Tennessee, the fire department shows up to put out a fire, and they realize that it's at a house where the guy didn't pay his $75 fee, so they sit there and watch the house burn down, and the fire spreads to the neighbor's house, because he let a house burn down, and now he's in jail for assault and battery. That's an example of it getting worse, and it's not going to get better until the money for the pay for things like fire or school or education is spent there. And like the last speaker said, is I think, why is it that people, you know, aren't engaged, or maybe not, more people aren't coming down here? Is because why listen to something to remind you how bad it is? Well, that's not fun.
I can tell you more stories about how bad it is. I don't think it's going to be exciting. It's going to be depressing, right? You want to hear about students in my class who don't have the ability to go see a counselor, or you can have other teachers up here talking about students who are facing homelessness, or I have students who have to get pulled out of class because they have to take care of some court system that's taking them out of their house or finding them this side or the other. There's plenty of stories that are going on. This week you have a whole week of furloughs in San Jose Unified School District. They just canceled class for the whole week and all the way through K-12. So all those parents who have to work, who can't afford to pay for daycare, what are they going to do? They're going to probably take off work, and many of them are just going to lose, it means losing their job. So I can give you plenty of stories of it getting worse, but if you don't think it can get better, it's useless. And so it really is important to realize that the money to pay for every single thing we need to pay for, education, healthcare, public transportation, and so on, is sitting there. It exists. It's not a rocket science to figure out how to pay for education. It's basic arithmetic. And it's a conscious choice to cut education. It's not a, oh, we don't know what to do, we're worried that maybe these corporations are going to leave if we tax them. I don't think Chevron with all this oil is going to leave. It's going to stay there because they're here because of the oil. These Silicon Valley computer companies aren't going to leave. They have millions of dollars spent on electronic equipment and servers. They're not going anywhere. And the millionaires aren't here because of, and the billionaires aren't in California because of the tax system. There have been higher taxes in the past. California's always been a wealthy country. The only reason that money isn't being spent on that is because we haven't forced them to spend on it yet. That's it. So if you like physics class, it's a physics equation. We haven't pushed against them hard enough to force them to pay for this, and that's it. As soon as we do, we'll see things change. But if we don't, we won't. And that's it. It won't. It will continue getting worse until that happens. Thank you.
I agree with everybody who has spoken so far, and I think everybody else who will speak will pretty much echo the same thing. I just want to say that if you don't say something, nothing is said, and I think everybody is saying something and how they feel, and that education is not only a right, it is power. And I'm really angry because I feel our power is being cut by our own government, by people we put into the office. I mean, what's going on here? What's wrong with this picture? I agree. And I'm especially concerned about two of the candidates who have, ran successful companies but laid off people. I'm afraid that if they do get into those positions, I'm afraid for California, deathly afraid. So let's just keep on going. Exercise your power. Speak up or else nothing is said. Education is a right. Education is power. Education is privilege. Sorry about that.
All right. Just to let everybody know, I want to touch bases on the Oscar grant situation. Same thing, but it's different. I've been working with students. I'm a dancer. I've been a dancer for the past 10 years at a recreation center, a nonprofit organization. They have cut the feet that have cut, budget cuts have cut their money down, leaving our students outside alone with no parenting, nobody at home to watch them. We have had 100 students when I was 14, 10 years ago, and we are down about 30 kids now. You can imagine where the other 70 kids really are and what they're really doing. I also read another quote when I did a project on this a couple months ago, and a kid came to school hungry. These kids are dropping out of school to feed themselves, one, because they have no access. So yes, they are out in the streets trying to get money just so they can eat something. And I think this matter starts honestly within us, because I go back every summer and volunteer. It takes 1 hour out of your guys' time. The only reason why they're eating our budget cuts, there's a lot more students that also are not coming to college. There's a lot more students that are not here that should be here today. And you guys are all here worried about yourselves. When it all comes down to one basic point, is how much time are we really giving up to those students who want to sit in the same chairs 5 and 10 years from now? You go to nonprofit organizations, after school programs, ask if they need an hour of your time. And if you need a tutor, there's some college students there just like you who will help you move along with yours, just like we're trying to get them to move along with theirs. It starts here with us, personally. It starts here with us. You give up that 1 hour of your time and help those students who are trying to get to where we want to be, where we are starting at. It doesn't take that much time. It's 1 hour. Thank you.
All right, I just wanted to talk about, to try to illustrate, you know, like why we're in this position and who put us here. But everyone in this school, we did not create the crisis that the economy is in right now. How many people in this room have investments in Goldman Sachs or have investments in Lehman Brothers? Nobody. We did not create this crisis, but we're certainly paying for it with our social services, you know, our education, our welfare, everything that they can take away from us. Because, you know, when you got money, you have power. Meg Whitman is damn near about to buy the governorship in California. She spent $120 million, like maybe more now, on that campaign. And you see that the people who have the money are really making the political decisions in California and in this country. So what's really going on is there's a class battle, and I think we should acknowledge it as a battle and engage in it, because they're engaging in it. They're taking steps to you know, cut everything we have, and we're letting them do it. So I think that's a good way to think about it. And you're in a public institution, you're in education, that's where you stand, and you should defend it. Thank you very much.